Welcome to MCN and the 2020 Triumph Street Triple RS. Now, it doesn't look too different on the outside, but I can assure you Triumph have made a lot of changes. We're here at Cartagena at its world launch, riding on the road and the track. I've literally just come in from the circuit now, and I've made a few notes, so I thought I'd share some thoughts with you and a few headline facts. So, this bike's out in November 2019 in dealers, and it costs £10,300. Now, that's a lot of bike for the money when you see all the stuff that it's got on it. And it's actually the same price as last year, which is quite impressive given the updates that we'll go into in a bit. It's got 121 bhp at the crank. Now, that's exactly the same as the previous generation bike, and it weighs 166 kilos, but that's a dry figure, so kind of an irrelevant figure, really. I reckon it probably weighs late 180s, early 190s, full of fuel. Triumph has sold over 90,000 street triples since they came out in 2007, which is an incredible amount. And it just goes to show they really know how to build a naked roadster. This is the RS model, so this is the top of the range. Previously, there's been an S and an R. Now, Triumph won't say if there's going to be a new version of those two variants, so we'll have to keep our eye on the upcoming bike shows to see what's what. So let's quickly go through what's new and see if it's worked or not. So let's talk about the engine. Top of the engine, we've got a new exhaust cam. It's also got a lighter crank, clutch and balancer. And of course, a Euro 5 exhaust, which is the main reason for this change. It's got two cats in it, but it's got a link pipe in the headers. It's got a sexy new stubby silencer, which is more free flowing. The engine, Triumph claim, makes 9% more torque, 9% more mid-range power, and 7% less inertia. How does it feel? Well, on the road, it's got so much grunt. 750 is the magic number, really. I know this is 765, but a GSX-R 750 was always a great bike. It's just the best balance between grunt, power, usability. There's loads of grunt out of corners, and the soundtrack, that rasping soundtrack, is to die for. And it's just got a little bit more of everything. And on the track, it feels like a super sport bike. You can rev it, it's involving, it's got nice grunt out the corners, loads and loads of speed, absolutely fantastic engine, great throttle response, it's hard to fault. Gearbox. Right, so the gearbox is more or less the same ratios. They've taken the backlash gears out of it, which makes everything lighter, makes everything crisper. No problems with the gears at all. There's also, the 2017 bike had a quick shifter, but the fact it didn't have a blipper was kind of quite obvious, really, when all the bikes of the time had one, but now it's got a blipper. So up and down through the gearbox, on the track, it's really, really smooth, and even low speed around town, you can use the electronics for the gears. So that's really, really good. Styling, okay, so it's new lights, new, more prominent daytime running lights, which are really, really cool. You've got new bodywork, new screen, new side panels, new belly pan, new tail unit. So it's kind of got a fresh new look, and it looks great in the flesh. Electronics. So this bike has got all the bells and whistles, traction control, wheelie control, ABS, rider modes. There's five rider modes. They've all been refined to take into account the new character of the engine. And it's also got a new dash. So 2017, the Street Triple got a really nice color dash, loads and loads of functions. And that's kind of evolved now with new colors, new graphics. And there's also Bluetooth, sat nav capability, GoPro capability. It's got it all. Let's talk about the chassis. So the chassis is based on the 675 Daytona, which is one of the sweetest handling sports bikes ever made. And that's how it started in the Street Triple. No massive changes. Still got the cast alley frame and swing arm. Still got the lightest wheels of any naked. You've got fully adjustable showers up front, fully adjustable O-rings at the rear, Brembos. The only real difference really is the Supercourser tyres are now version 3s and not version 2s. But wow, does it handle well. This is one of the best things about the Daytona. It handles like a pucker pucker sports bike. But the best thing is, because it's got a comfortable riding position, you don't have to pay for all that sharp handling and fantastic brakes. On the road, it just glides along, goes where you want to put, where you want it, and on the track, it's got loads and loads of grip. So they're the sum of the changes, really. I'd say if you've got the existing Street Triple RS, this isn't a big enough step to warrant selling your bike and getting a new one. But if you're in the market for a sports roadster, and really this does everything, and you should be, the Street Triple RS is a fantastic bike and a great step forward.